Hi there. It's Penelope and Amanda Hite, and we're going to talk about how to use social media for recruiting. Amanda's first topic is why do recruiters suck, which was totally surprising to me because I go to all these completely crappy conferences all the time, and the only good ones I ever go to are the recruiting ones because the people are really fun and outgoing and they drink a lot at night and they all know each other. And so I think the first thing we'll talk about is why recruiters suck, because I don't really know.
I think it's really the recruiting process that is broken. And so if you think about, we're using the same recruiting systems and processes that we did a long time ago. They're not filtering talent right. And so I think recruiters are really not venturing out. They're not taking risks. They're not building relationships. They whine and they complain that they get too many resumes and that's a bad thing. And so I think they need to reinvent the process.
So I hear recruiters have to take risks, and I think, okay, well, that's the interesting thing, because really what's interesting is why people take risks and why they don't. And I gotta tell you guys, the people who take risks in their careers are good, and the people who don't take risks suck. It's just how it is. You can pretend that that's not true, but it's true. And also, Amanda and I have both worked for ourselves, and so that's really scary and hard and very risky, so of course we're going to tell you how to take risks. I want to tell you that Amanda drove here in a BMW, which is a little bit surprising because I don't really think of recruiters as people who are making truckloads of money. And also, Amanda just started working for herself, so I was really surprised because when I started working for myself, I was like, not just starving, but my kids were starving, and it was really scary. And it's not like Amanda's eating her BMW, so I think she's making tons of money. So, okay, so these are the questions.
Sure.
The first question is what kind of risks people should take, and it's that next question is how do you afford a BMW when you just started working for yourself?
So
are you a call girl? What are you on?
No. Multiple streams of income. Uh-huh. Not that though. Uh-huh. I don't think everybody should quit their job like I did. I had $64 in the bank. I had like $64 in the bank, and
and she spent like a lot of that on blue hair because that's what she did.
Yep,
the
that's
last
right.
She did.
I spent that $64 for lunch that day, and I just knew how to. I could recruit with my eyes closed, and I knew how to make money doing that. So we did that out of the gates.
You left your in-house job and just started recruiting.
Yeah,
that's so funny because I always think like when I want to tell Ryan and Ryan to fuck off, you know, during the day at Brazen Careerist, I always think, well, you know what, Brazen Careerist is full of people. I could just be a recruiter if I get fired.
Totally.
Like I feel like if you are good at connecting with people, you can be a recruiter.
Put something on your blog that says, "I am looking for this."
Yeah, why don't I do that?
I should charge like 25% of their salary.
I should totally do that.
Absolutely.
So that's my next thing. Okay,
so yeah,
and then will I have a BMW? Because right now I have a very shitty car. Not very shitty, but kind of shitty.
Do you know what's interesting about the BMW? It's my fifth one, and I've
when you had $64 in the bank? I should sell my BMW.
I could not go get a Kia if I wanted to. I've always financed through BMW, so they're the only ones that loan me the money. I had a rough first year too. I made 18 grand. That's a lot of risk.
You cashed out your 401k.
Yeah.
Hold on. I cashed out mine, and I'm in like the IRS just started garnishing my wages. That's how fucked up my taxes are from cashing out my 401k.
Well,
and the taxes are like 40%.
Yeah, well, I had to pay the taxes.
Oh yeah. Well, I didn't have the money to pay the taxes.
Well, you were recruiting.
Wait, this isn't a question.
That was a nice comment.
Eric, it would be tough because we're actually both take up a lot of space, so you would be a little bit squished. Also, being sandwiched between us would just, I'm already getting a migraine from having to like make room for someone else to talk, so making room for two people to talk would be too much.
She's thrilled because I make her look thinner.
Oh yeah, that's also
because I'm like twice Ryan's size.
Ryan is really small, and also he wears sunny, I'm so chirpy colors, and Amanda wore black. I like that.
Definitely.
Okay, how do you tell people that they have to be an organizational, like they have to help the organization move to social media when, like, why don't they just leave? Why is it their job to bang their head against the wall telling the CEO that Twitter's important? Like, why do you want to save your CEO's butt? Why don't you just go to a place that gets it?
I think you absolutely should. I told a recruiter the other day from a really big company, like you all know this big restaurant chain.
Uh-huh.
And their restaurant chain, she couldn't get on LinkedIn. She was blocked from LinkedIn.
The recruiter was blocked from LinkedIn. That's hilarious.
She's blocked from YouTube. And so I think...
Blocked from YouTube. How does she see your best videos then? How did she even know about you? You guys should all watch Amanda's video about going to Twitter. It's really, really funny. Also, it's really well edited. Did you edit?
My first edited video.
See, this would be really good edited if Amanda were editing this, but we don't record our videos. We just piss everyone off by...
I think they're recording. We say that every week.
And then, I don't know. I mean, companies paying you to go in and tell their employees to quit their job. I don't get it.
Well, I'm not telling them to quit their job, but in this particular case, it was a friend of mine, and I said, you know, if they're not going to change and you can't recruit using these tools, like, you should leave. Yeah.
So what do you tell people, though? Okay, so I have this all the time. It's a company that is not using social media to recruit, and they're having trouble getting top talent, and the senior management doesn't buy into using social media. So what do you tell those people?
Say, here's our social media plan. What you say is, hey, we've, you know, done some work with our recruiting strategy, we've gathered all these smart people together, and this is our new...
Oh my God, you're so retarded with that.
I'm over it. Okay, I'm serious. I'm just going to use it. So I think what they need to do is, this is our new recruiting strategy. And they're not looking at all the details anyways, right?
And so you just say
this is our recruiting strategy, because then you're not selling this new... It's like the products and the tools you use. Okay, so we're going to cold call on this new cell phone. You don't talk about that. It's just a communication tool. And so you have to sell it as your overall strategy. Hey, we're going to be working on our employment brand. We're going to recruit influencers in the industry. You just talk about those types of things and less about the tools. We spend way too much time talking about Twitter and Facebook and LinkedIn. You know, those are just venues, like different brands of phones that we use.
That is so smart.
Thank you.
People could do that. You could use that for everything. I mean, you sound like an idiot talking about the tools you're going to use anyway.
Yes,
you should promote big picture thinking.
As
someone who's never been in HR but has been on Fortune 500 a lot, I mean, I just got to say, everyone hates HR. I think we all know that. So if everyone hates HR and recruiters are always a cost center, why do people want to be in that department? Why? It's not a good career move. I mean, it's a good career move to be an independent recruiter because they make so much money, and also ERE is totally a fun conference, so you can go to that if you're an independent recruiter. But what is it?
I don't know. I think there's good people in HR. I think especially in the social media space, like, there's some of the leading innovators as far as that are out there. I think there's people in HR that have better brands than some of the marketing people in their same companies.
Totally agree. So why don't those people, totally agree.
Yeah.
They should leave HR and go to marketing, because you make more money in marketing and you have more influence. And you see a lot of people will go up the ladder from marketing to CEO. Have you ever seen anyone go from HR to CEO? No, doesn't happen.
But don't you think HR and marketing should like work together, especially recruiting and marketing?
Well, I think the marketers should all be fired if they don't know how to use social media, and HR should be marketing.
Yeah.
Why is it? So then, if HR should be marketing, then you should not be in HR. You should be in marketing doing HR stuff, and that's like where your future is. Do you think that? Totally.
Because I think, you know, we have all of these job seekers, and it's so overwhelming because we're getting so many resumes, but then everybody's starving for customers and guests. And so why wouldn't, you know, HR, recruiting, and marketing work together? Because
it's all branding. It should all be branding.
It's all branding. It's attracting people to your brand.
Exactly. And if a recruiter's doing a good job of like building a network, well, you could do anything with that network. You could recruit, you could sell your product, you could make
totally.
A focus group.
Yep.
Okay, we have to answer some questions. It feels more interactive. No, what companies are doing social media well?
Sure.
So I'm always like, oh, Zappos, just go follow them on Twitter. That's what I answer because I get tired.
We have some clients that are doing a great job. We have Monicals Pizza, which, you know, they have pizza chains in Illinois, and they have like 30,000 Facebook fans. They do a great job of connecting and bringing their people together. We have...
Where are you from that you just said Illinois? Where did you grow up?
Oh, I'm not from there. So Monicals Pizza.
It's Illinois, not Illinois.
Oh, I don't know.
Where'd you grow up?
Everywhere. I had like 32 homes.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sorry.
No. So, and then Pacific Catch, one of my favorite new clients, Pacific Catch, you know, they immediately after getting into the game, you know, got a blog, started getting a voice, started doing tweet-ups,
meeting
the people online.
Tell Tell them the blog.
It's pacificcatch.com.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. So pacificcatch.com. And they're actually, you can earn a swarm badge, a four square swarm badge, where they're on four square day, which is April 16th, I think. I don't know. Four square day, you can go to the restaurant and earn a swarm badge.